Welcome everybody to my next video. Today we're looking at the Canadian IMP, or MRE, chicken a la king. Really small world moment for me. I have a buddy who was in the US Air Force since the early 90s, and he came back from where he was stationed and visited us back at home, and he brought a few entrees from his MREs for us to try, more on a dare, I think, than anything else. And the one I got was chicken a la king. He made us eat, made me eat it cold, which didn't really make much difference, but I just laughed it off and I said, buddy, I like this, I enjoyed it. So it was kind of a joke on him, but this is the first MRE I've ever tried. The entree is chicken a la king. So today, that's what we're gonna do. So this one is manufactured 2013. That's got a 3-year shelf life, good for 2016, which it just is now. I'm gonna take this, open it up, and go through all the products inside. Stay with me. All right, so there's the package opened up. Everything's intact. Doesn't there's any issues inside there. I'm just gonna take these things out as I get to them and put them on the tray here in front of me. So on top, we have the after dinner mint. In the middle, we have bread. Over here, we've got some condiments. I have a peanut butter and another peanut butter. We've got a beverage, hot chocolate. And here's a new one to me. Branded product, Reese's Pieces Peanut Butter Candy. Exciting. We have an orange sports drink. We have instant coffee. Another orange sports drink. So this one is labeled as a, doesn't say lunch or dinner. Some of the ones I've had before have done that. So this has got a good gamut of food here. We've got the nice long spoon, got the paper towel. This is for your beverage mixing. The usual cheap coffee whitener, hot sauce, not jalapeno. It says aged red cayenne peppers, vinegar, salt, and garlic. All right, put that over here. Condiments, got real sugar. The last one that I opened up, we actually had, it wasn't real sugar in there, the sweetener. Pack of matches. And last accessory is a pack of gum. And after that, I have a wet wipe. And I'm gonna look down on the bottom for the toothpick. There it is. One plastic wrap toothpick. That's everything from the bag. And now the important parts, the mains. We have the promise of poulet a la king, chicken a la king, and I'll hold up the details here for you and pause it if you need to. And I'll scroll over here so you can get all the ingredients. Again, pause it if you need to. That's our main and our surprise. Our second is fruit cocktail. Well, there you go. And the ingredients. And there you be. So I'm going to take this, I'm going to heat up the main, I'm going to get myself organized, and we'll be back to do some taste testing. Stay with me. All right, so we're back here. So we're going to try the bread. I've tried this lots of times. I got a couple little tests I like to do. There's a nice tear notch there. They've changed the wording on the package. Maybe they saw some of my older videos. It now says, do not eat desiccant package, rather than the large do not eat that was on the bread package before. If you see some of my previous videos, you'll notice that. Maybe they're watching too. And hey, we get some nutritional deets. All right, hold on to that, pause it if you need to. Sorry, I just ripped the ingredients apart here. There's the English version as best I can. If not, brush up on your Francaise and figure it out. Okay, the normal test. It's, again, basically like eating the two end pieces of a loaf of bread because it's baked round with the crust. We'll do the squish test. That's a really good rebound. Double squish test. We'll do the tear it apart test. Nicely resilient but yielding. And we'll do the sniff. It smells like bread. We'll do the taste by itself. Mm-hmm. It's a little bit sweet but quite palatable. Now we could put the peanut butter on there. If you're a little more crazy, you can put hot sauce on there. Or you can save it, and with your main, you can dip it into the sauce, or even dip it into the fruit sauce. If you really have a hard time eating this, use the fruit sauce when you're finished to get the fruit out of there. Dip the bread in there and gain your calorie count from that. All right, move on to the next thing. We have here Reese's Pieces Peanut Butter Candy. And again, they're getting better at the packaging here. More information, ingredients, there's your nutritional information. Okay. Now, my son partially deflated peanuts. I'm not sure what that is. Probably defatted. Put an extra L in there when I didn't need to. Oh, those look tasty. A little bit of degradation in there. You can see down here, there's a little bit of crumblies, so one or two of them. And there's one. And there's two. There's a few that are banged around a little bit. That package wasn't vacuum sealed, though, so they do have some room to roll around. So in transit, those probably do have the possibility of getting beat up a bit. There you go, there's a few. That's not going to hurt the product whatsoever. I'll take two or three of those. Yeah, tastes like a Reese's Pieces. A little peanut butter treat. That's a score. I like that. That would probably be a hit in the trade market. If you are set up to receive MREs or IMPs, there's a lot of horse trading that goes around at mealtime, I think. Some guys will have preference for one thing, some will have preference for another. That's probably a popular item. Now we're back. We're going to look at the fruit cocktail. Get it out of this little paper box here. And it'll be in a foil packet. Goes to recycling. This one, as well as the Alaking Maine, I'm excited to say, is back to the Baxter's company. And that's made in Canada. This says right here, Baxter's Canada Inc., St. Hyacinthe, province of Quebec. So I like that. You know, I don't like my outsourcing of military meal ingredients. I'm just going to look back and see if this Reese's Pieces say anything about where they're from. Packed by Ropac, Montreal, Quebec. Excellent. I like it. So I've got two tear notches here. I'm going to use the top one because I'm going to pour it out. If you're using the spoon, you could use the lower one and make it a little easier to reach into. Of course, it's going to be a devil to open. All right, that took longer than it should have, so I brought you off screen. There's the fruit cocktail, just like the stuff you get in a can. Pour that out. Let's see what we've got here. Get all that syrup. You want to get all those calories, everything you can, out of these meals. One little pesky piece of the orange stuff. Oh, that was great. That's good and empty. Off to the side. So we have things like grapes. There's orange, I believe, mango, those types of fruits on there. You can go back to the close-up of the ingredients list, which I didn't read before I started. And there's my favorite, the cherry. Mm-hmm. Good consistency. It still has some feel to it. It hasn't gone totally to mush. There's still some crunch and a bit of resistance in those fruits that I just tried in that bite. Not overly sweet, but it is syrupy, of course. If you've ever had a fruit cocktail out of a can, that's what you should expect right there. Still waiting for the main to heat up. I'm just going to go through the beverages here because I've done this on numerous videos, so I'm actually kind of saving these sports drinks for later this summer. I'm going to take them to work with me and use them rather than do them up here on the video. But this is orange drink. It is a sports drink like those Aid-type products you would find in your regular grocery store. It's going to give you the sugary sweetness, give you the calories, and here's the backdrop of the drink package again. So I've got two of them. They're going to go into my storage bin and they get used later in the summer. If you need to see those, just check a couple of my earlier videos and I usually do drink them. The instant coffee, whitener, and sugar. I'm not a coffee guy, so I don't do these. If you're a video maker on YouTube and you want me to send you one set like this, just drop me a message and I will happily send it to you if I have a set to give, as long as you promise to try and make a video describing your wonderful interaction with that product. The other is hot chocolate. The hot chocolate I've had numerous times, it is just like the stuff you get at the grocery store, so there's no need for me to go ahead and sample that because I've had enough of them. This also goes into the storage, and that goes for when me and the kid go for a hike, we store that up. The gum. It's Chiclets. I haven't found out yet if it's a dental type gum that does any teeth cleaning or not. Doesn't taste like anything other than regular Chiclets, so pretty straightforward. Toothpick. It's a tiny piece of wood to get the food out of your teeth with pointy ends. Handy wipe is a wet wipe. Non-medicinal, non-steriling. It's just water and fragrance and a little towel. Helps you clean up. Matches. Matches make fires. You can burn your refuse if you needed to in the field. You can start a fire and then burn your refuse, or you can just strike a match after you use the latrine and hopefully make it more pleasant for the next guy that has to go in. So we have also the condiment of peanut butter, which I've tasted before. The consistency of this is smooth. The last MRE I had just yesterday, actually I made a video, was the first one I've ever encountered chunky peanut butter, which was cool. A nice little change. These taste like peanut butter, they look like peanut butter, and in fact they are peanut butter. Those also go into the summer camping stores. The after dinner mint. It looks like and tastes like the same thing you would get out of that little dish when you leave the restaurant when you're finished. These are sold by the hundreds of thousands, I'm sure. A small candy, not fortified, no vitamins, no idea. I just give that to my kid and let him take care of business. If you were surviving though, all of these products have calories. Don't be picky, don't be choosy. The beverage bag. This is designed to use for either hot or cold beverage. The top line here is for sports drinks. The bottom line would be for your hot chocolate. It opens up with a zip top, and it also has this nice flat bottom. When you put stuff in the bag, it opens that up and you can stand that bag up. Very handy. Doesn't do it well when it's empty though. Okay, we'll be back just in a moment with the main. All right, we are back with the main. You know, if I say, all right, we are back, six times in a video, can somebody please give me a virtual slap on the chin? I gotta watch this, I'm getting way too repetitive in my speech here. We have chicken a la king. This has actually softened up a lot. You can see it's become quite malleable compared to what it was at room temperature, which was fairly solid. I tried the tear notches on this, and that worked a little better than the fruit salad one earlier. Excuse my reach while I put the garbage where it goes. First off, I get an aroma already. Yeah, that looks pretty tasty. Smells good. Here's a close-up for y'all. Big chunks of chicken in that. Goopy yellow sauce. Almost looks like that smothered chicken sauce that I had not long ago, which may or may not have been released yet as a video. These videos, what happens is normally it's on the weekend. This is lunchtime. Saturdays and Sundays is when I can put the boy in his room with mom's iPad or other virtual digital device, tablet or whatever. And I can get, if I wanted to, if the batteries lasted long enough and I really had the time, I could probably get 4 hours out of it before he came out of there. And my wife is off at work, which means I don't have to do anything special for lunch other than myself and make sure the boy is fed at some point before he goes into his room. Okay, enough waffling. This is chicken a la king. There's some creamy saucy bit there, and there's some thinner sauce, so I may have wanted to stir that before I brought it out of the package. That may have something to do with how I heated it. I put it in a bath of water in a pot on the stove. And if the upper portion of the food stuff, which I did stuff it down with a spoon, didn't get as much heat as the lower portion, it may have not thickened up. Okay, so you can see here, looks kind of goopy and creamy sauce. Down here, very thin. And even after a quick stir, as you've seen I've just done, didn't seem to want to go together. But enough. First off, chicken. Let's just dig around here. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. There's at least 20 pieces of chicken here, roughly 1 centimeter by 1 centimeter. Put those down next to the pieces. You can see they're pretty good size. I'll try it by itself. Mmm. Good stuff. That tastes like a piece of chicken you just cut off of a cooked chicken breast. Thoroughly cooked, not mushy. The flavor of this is nice. It's rather, it's not exciting, it's not aggressive, but it is what you think of when you think of homemade or canned chicken a la king, or chicken in a white sauce. There's mushroom in here, like a stem or something. That's mushroom, I'll try it. Mushrooms, there's a green peas. And there's the green pepper. Something orange in here. It feels like a skin. I'm gonna say red pepper. And that looks like the gamut. There's no rice or anything amiss. It's just sauce, chicken, and a bit of veg. Look at that. Like that was identifiable as mushroom right there. There's no hiding that. It's not a tiny mince, that bit. That is a slice of a mushroom cap right there. I like that. Tastes good. All right, if you wanted to spice it up a bit, we'd go with the hot sauce. I will sacrifice this because I want to see what kind of hot sauce it is. Tear the corner off. It says it was a red pepper base, so take a random spoonful, put it here, put a little squirt in, see if we can get this on camera. There we go, it's a pretty healthy squirt. And we'll try that. get a bit of the nose of it, just a bit of the smell as you bring it to your mouth. But on the tongue, it's similar to a Tabasco type product. So if you like it spicy, you've got the option. I like that because I've had a few MREs that were bland or distasteful, and a good healthy helping of hot sauce could have turned that around real good. I'm gonna eat this. This is my brunch. See my hand shaking a little bit. I'm low on blood sugar, I think, because I haven't eaten anything yet today, and it's just shooting at 1 o'clock almost. I will say, as I do always, thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please like, share, and subscribe. You can also find me on Instagram, where I post pictures of a lot of other things other than just MREs and such. And look forward to see you again. Thanks again. Take care.